Good morning and welcome back to Charlie's Diary, guys. This is Justy, and today we are going to see about game algorithm. Okay, now this has been in my list for quite some time. Now, because of the work and my family life, I couldn't complete this in time. Apologies for that. Now, today we are going to cover certain aspects of the algorithm. I can't do the whole thing. It has so many parts. As you all know, it is just a complex game, and because it has so many parts, I cannot cover everything. So today we are just going to concentrate only on the outcome prediction, is what we can say, or the results, how the results are gained, how the matches are being compared, okay, likewise, and how they all come in terms with the final result that you gave. Okay, so we will look at that today, and based on that we will see. And there is also a section for training. All these are recorded in game, okay, and you will understand once you get a look at it. Okay, so before that, I want to also tell you, you know, those who haven't subscribed, subscribe. Okay, so this game, as you look into it, okay, before even starting a match, the main thing that happens is, you know, you set a match between two players or two teams, okay, the home goals and the away goals are taken into account. So what means is the home and away plays a part here, and your history, your club history also plays a part, and based on that, three different labels, win, draw or defeat, is generated, right? So that is when what happens when you actually set a match between two people, be it in your leagues, be it in your Champions League or cups, okay, or even association matches. Now what happens in a match is, you know, each individual player is being recorded statistically. The factors that are taken into consideration is their stats, their skills, their training routines, how many times they have been trained over the years. All these are taken into consideration here, and based on that, a graph is plotted, or you can say an expression is formed, you know, which totally gives you the total rating of the player. Okay, now the overall rating also plays a part. Overall rating in the sense the quality of the player, also the game rating. The game rating is formed by considering various factors into the game, such as how he performed in the last matches, plus how he is performing today, or the game that you are playing with him. Okay, all these factors together correlate into the team performance, or the overall team performance. Okay, now the overall team performance is actually the mixture of the home player. For the home team, it is the home players, and for the away team, it is the away players. And based on that, you get the total team performance. Okay, now for a match, it is 90 minutes. We all know it is 90 minutes, right? And in the 90 minutes, you have 20 plays approximately, and 83 minutes is actually autopilot, and you can only control 7 minutes of it, right? So whatever you do in those 7 minutes is actually what you can control. So always favor your arrangement into something where you actually favor the autopilot. That is where the formation and the tactics plays a big part. Okay, and that is where you have to, you know, really look into setting the right kind of formation. Now this is what happens. Okay, the input is given, and all players are statistically recorded what each of them do in the game, and based on that, an expression is formed to actually determine how they perform in the game, and based on that, a team performance probability is formed, right? Now this will give you another expression which in turn decides the outcome of the match. Okay, so basically what I want to say is, all these mathematical things you don't have to consider. What you have to look into is the individual player performance and the total team ratings. So if you have one player who is very good, even that can topple the results. Okay, just one player is enough, and based on these two performance, the outcome is calculated by the difference of the two. Okay, sometimes you might notice a wild card being played. Okay, where when these numbers come into a similar number, a random team actually wins. That is where these trolled results happen. Okay, now that is not all. When they actually look into a defeat or a win, they actually take the last 10 matches also into account, and only then the final result is correlated. Okay, now the outcome calculation is based on your player's performance, which includes skills, training, morale and rating and whatnot. Now the team performance, club history is really important, and the last 10 matches or 15 matches or whatever, and all these are separately done for league, cup and Champions League, home separately, away separately. That is why some teams will perform very good in leagues, and some will not perform that great in what do you call in the cups or the Champions League. Okay, and based on this, goal variables are formed in what ratio they have to score, and according to the calculations they make, if a team concedes in home like say 1 and away he scores 3, based on that the score ratio is formed. Okay, so always take into account the club history of the games. Okay, and whenever you play a match against somebody, you know what I want to say is, yes, I forgot to tell you this. Now yesterday one of my subscribers gave me ear full of abuse because he followed one of the tactics which I explained in one of my videos, and he happened to lose a few matches. I guess what he said was 5 matches, but I don't think he will lose 5 consecutively. But anyway, what I want to tell you is, don't take me as the wizard of the game. My only intention was to help you all, and I never meant any ill for anybody. Okay, whatever I do is because whatever I knew I am sharing. Okay, and I don't wish to purposefully hurt anybody. So and when you abuse, you can do it personally. Don't come out in the open, and you know, don't share it in social media. I am happy to take feedbacks, but the thing is, you know, I was really bummed out yesterday because he kind of, you know, abused the hell out of me, and kind of, you know, told, like, you know, he cursed the day that he subscribed to this channel. So please don't think like that. And if at all you want to follow any of my tactics, please do arrange a friendly and try it for yourself, and then only deploy that into your game, because you know whatever I do here is based on real life football experiences. And also I want to clear the air. He also mentioned that I am a hacker, that is why I am winning all the matches. No, you can see my club history here. I don't win all the matches. If I was a hacker, I would have won all the matches, right? So coming back to the algorithm, these club history is really important. You can see goals scored, goals against. Okay, these things are taken into account every time you set a match, and this is being separately recorded for leagues, separately recorded for Champions League, separately recorded for your your cups, and even for friendlies and associations. Okay, all these are taken into account for every matches. So whenever you are playing a game, they take the data what they have stored, and it includes the training also. Okay, there are a lot of things which I didn't cover because of the time restrictions. So suppose someone is actually tanking for a 2 to 3 seasons. So what happens is, each season has around 51 games, and omitting the cups and the initial group stages of the Champions League, you easily get around 35 to 40 games. So if you tank 2 seasons, that leaves you with 80 games, and 80 losses in your club history will take time. Now when they compare last 10 to 15 matches, all they see is losses, and the conceding ratio is really high. So one fine morning, if you think that okay, this is the time that I have to get in and I will start winning matches, no, it will not happen like that. You will have to start playing. It will take at least one and a half season to actually recover your team into a full performing team. So that is why most of the players who try to, you know, wake up in the middle of the night and start playing this will not, and is not getting that, you know, exact performance, because the algorithm is designed in such a way that, you know, it compares the last few matches. That is why when you train a new player, now I had to train this new player because, you know, my league is just, you know, bogus. I can't compete with anybody there. Everybody has you know, high performing teams, and this season is the worst season for me, because right now currently I'm placed at 4th or 5th, I guess, and there is no way that I will win this season, and I will be surprised if I win any silverware at all. And the same thing is with the cups and the Champions League also, all heavy teams, and everybody suddenly looks like, you know, they are all superhuman teams. And so the stats and the skills are, see, look at this player now. From 230 games, he has scored around 400 goals. Now that is only in leagues, similarly in club matches. Now such a player, if you have in your team, will give you good results, because based on the rating of this player alone, the team performance can be improved. So your goal should be, you know, how to improve your player ratings every match. So that will actually give you better chances of, you know, winning every matches. So try to do that. And if you want info on how to improve your player ratings, just write in query box. I can give you information regarding that, or I'll make a separate video for that. So always before going, I want to tell you this once more. If you are setting a match, set it up with somebody from your same level who is higher than you and someone who stays number one in the league. Those players are the ones whom you should select to evaluate your team, right? And based on that, come to a conclusion, check your player ratings and make few changes that will improve your player ratings. Okay, with that, this is Justy signing off from Charlie's Diary. Take care.